Peripheral nerve injury. Classification. There are two classifications of PNI which are put forth by Sedom and Sutherland. Sedom classification of PNI is neuropraxia, axonotomesis and neurotomesis. Sutherland's classification, grade 1 to grade 5. Grade 1 or first degree is neuropraxia. Grade 2 involves loss of axon, continuity with preservation of endoneurium and fascicular structure. Grade 3, third degree is a mixed axonotomic neurotomic type of injury. Grade 4, loss of axons, endoneurium, perineurium with absence of fascicular structure. Grade 5, complete neurotomesis. Assessment of peripheral nerve injury, observation, examination. In examination, sensory reflexes, tone, MMT, sweat function test, ninhydrin test, chinizarin test, start test, galvanic skin resistance test. Management for peripheral nerve injury, acute stage. This is a stage of total paralysis, hence the main aim of the management will be as under: to maintain the properties of the muscle. This can be achieved by stimulating paralyzed muscles using interrupted galvanic current. Galvanic current can stimulate denervated muscle as they are of longer pulse duration. Artificially contracting muscles will ensure a proper blood supply of as well as help in maintenance of excitation, contraction and coupling. Faraday current cannot be used for these purposes as it is for of shorter pulse duration and hence does not stimulate denervated muscles. To maintain joint range of motions, passive range of motion is giving to the paralyzed area so that the joint range of motion can be maintained. The flexibility of the muscles can also be maintained by gentle sustained stretch to prevent any abnormal attitude of the affected part. Splinting is necessary for the purpose of giving a functional position and also to prevent overstretching of the affected muscles. To maintain the skin structure, texture, this management is very essential while treating patients with trophic skin changes. The affected area should be kept supple by applying some moisturizer or oil so that skin breakdown can be prevented. Care of anesthetic hand or foot. The involved part should be inspected regularly for some wounds or skin color changes. In case of any wound, immediate antiseptic precaution should be taken. The patient should be asked to avoid extreme temperatures. Protective gloves may be used for hand to prevent injury by sharp objects. Soft shoes, preferably with toe windows, may be worn to protect the foot. The skin should be kept moist but not wet. Proper hygienic measures should be taken to prevent any infection to the affected area. Prevention of edema. This is possible in case of gross paralysis of the upper limb and lower limb, like a brachial plexus or sciatic nerve injury respectively. Edema occurs due to gravity-dependent position of limb coupled with lack of muscular tone, hence elastocere bandage and elevation is given to prevent edema. Consistent monitoring. The patient should be monitored by a therapist quite regularly for checking any deterioration or improvement in the condition. SDC is done every week to note the signs of innovations. Recovery stage. In this stage, innovation has started and the muscles begin to show active contraction. Thus, the aim of treatment will be as under: muscle re-education. Once the MMT grade is 1 or if the SDC is showing signs of innovations, then Faraday re-education should be given to the muscle. In this treatment, Faraday current is used to produce the action of a muscle and the patient is asked to put in voluntary effort along with the current. The intensity of the current is slowly decreased during the subsequent session so that the patient will be able to perform the action without any assistance. Combination of Faraday re-education and biofeedback. This method is very effective to bring about muscle re-education as the biofeedback helps the patient to understand the outcome of his effort and thus can motivate the patient to contribute more. Strengthening. Once the muscle power has reached MMT grade 2, then strengthening exercises can be started in gravity elevated plane or inclined plane till the power reaches 3. Re-education board or table is helpful in gradually changing the muscle work from gravity eliminated plane to against gravity. Once the muscle power reaches grade 3, then resistor exercises can be given manually or with springs, pulleys, hydrotherapy, etc. Functional retraining. Although the muscle may appear to be strengthened to the maximum grade, but it is essential to incorporate functional activity into the rehabilitation program. This is necessary because an increase in strength of a muscle for one activity does not necessarily guarantee efficient performance for other activity. Thus, for hand, various gripping activities, for lower limbs, activities like level walking, staircase climbing, etc. needs to be given. It should be noted that the therapist should wait for adequate time for recovery to take place, then that can be calculated considering the rate of regeneration, 1 mm per day on an average, and the site of lesion. However, once the patient does not recover in the predicted time, then based on various investigation and evaluation, he may be sent for plastic surgery intervention. This is essential to give some functional independence to the patient. These treatment principles can be applied for all the nerves.